Today's lesson is on dynamic stability. The dynamic stability of the plane tells us how the plane will react to external disturbances like gusts of wind, as well as how the plane's handling can react to maneuvers like rolling, spinning, Dutch roll, and other maneuvers. In our work in DBF, dynamic stability revolves around four numerical factors: damping ratio, abbreviated lowercase zeta, natural frequency, damped natural frequency, and time period, abbreviated tau. The different categories are short period, Phugoid, roll, Dutch roll, and spiral. The first two are longitudinally directed. Short period mode is a heavily damped oscillation. The motion is a rapid pitching of the aircraft about the center of gravity. Phugoid motion is the one in which there is a large amplitude variation of airspeed, pitch angle, and altitude, but no angle of attack change. These can both be improved by making the coefficient of moment slope more negative at whatever angle, or by increasing the moment of inertia around the center of mass. Roll subsidence mode is simply the damping of rolling motion, which is stability in the lateral direction. This is made more stable with a dihedral angle on the wings and tail surfaces. Dutch roll is a type of aircraft motion where the plane yaws and rolls in the same direction. Therefore, Dutch roll damping and frequency concerns the ability of the plane to right itself after such motion. Dutch roll stability is improved by adding dihedral and sweeping of the wings. Spiral divergence is caused by simultaneous rolling and an increase in speed. Spiraling uncontrollably will almost certainly result in a fatal crash, destroying the plane. To analyze, go to these four dots here, labeled root locus view, and we will start with the longitudinal direction. Short period. When the mass is placed farther back, which here is the black dot, the natural frequency is of a smaller absolute value. You can also see the tail farther back design, which is golden brown, and the larger horizontal tail, which is orange, are much closer to the x-axis than the y-axis. This indicates a high damping ratio for both of those designs, which have a higher moment contribution from the stabilizer surface. Phugoid stability. Lower lift-to-drag ratio will cause higher phugoid damping, which can be analyzed as the relative angle from the y-axis to the x-axis. If you zoom in on the center dots, you have to zoom in quite a lot, you will see that the flaps low lift-to-drag analysis is farther over angle-wise compared to the other dots. This indicates higher damping. And now we will switch over to the lateral analysis side. Roll, which is also located at the center. You can slightly see that the dihedral red dot is farther to the left compared to the dots at the center. This is good. The more a dot is to the left here, the more stable it is. So a dihedral design will have greater roll stability. Now on to Dutch roll. You can see here that the high X moment of inertia purple dot and larger horizontal tail have a lower Dutch roll frequency because they have a smaller value on the X-axis. The larger tail farther back, and larger vertical tail, the bluish circle at the top, are more damped than the others. Spiral. Stability. In order from lowest to highest natural frequency, it is high X moment of inertia, larger horizontal tail, tail farther back, mass farther back, regular, larger vertical tail, dihedral, tapered, and finally swept. Please note that this does not necessarily reflect the most effective strategy, for stabilizing in these modes because changes in mass do not pare well to adding dihedral, sweep, or tail edits. For consideration of if the plane is dynamically stable enough, the numbers can be placed in this Excel doc here, which has acceptable ranges listed for some but not all quantities. There will be a later video describing how to plot dynamic stability on several graphs used in the aerospace industry or for assessing stability. Here is a photo regarding all the different strategies for changing stability parameters. That is all there is for today. Thank you for listening and have a good day.